Greetings, angels of the New Earth Alliance, rising up as a cohesive force, connected through the rainbow bridges. Nothing can stop us now. Victory to the light, love has won. With our star nations and our star families, we are in the process of clearing and cleaning up and resolving the thousands and millions of years of suffering and trauma in this realm and in all timelines. We're all being activated. We're connecting to our higher selves, our higher frequencies, our highest light here now. Today, this morning, as the sun shone brilliantly upon the lands, the crystalline diamond codes were coming in fully today, and these energies of Venus rising, the goddess energies, we're seeing this on the Schumann charts today with the 13 hertz, the 13 of the divine goddess, and the kin 234 today, the last day of the white wind wave spell. This is a powerful day, also 3322, March 3rd, 2020, we have the two master codes, the master numbers 22 and 33, in this 33 portal. So we are rising up and raising our consciousness, raising our energy, raising our frequency. We're feeling this in many different ways as we're all being activated. At the end of this transmission today, I'm going to transmit and read a sacred poem, sacred code from here in the moon, and I will tap into my most powerful Venusian energy, the Venus goddess energy of the healing blue waters. Many will receive an activation through this energy, through the tone and through the words, through the frequencies. So stick around to the end. We will transmit that to all of you. And several of you have requested that I read you all a bedtime story of the Venusians connecting with Nikola Tesla, which I plan on doing in the next couple weeks when I free up some time here. And I'll do it in a series and see how it goes. I'll release one and then see what kind of results and responses I get through these readings of some older texts. And if I get good results, I'll do more of those from my Library of Alexandria in the sacred halls of Amanti. So today's first transmission is from Isis Channelings, 3-3 Portal, Midwives of the Order of Isis, and the 3-strand DNA 13-22. A certain piece of information came in a recent channeling session with a client, and though I'm not sure how it exactly relates today, 3-3 Portal, I'm guided to share it on this portal day. The information that came in was that in the ancient Chem, priestess of the Order of Isis were trained as midwives, portal holders, for the very delicate transformational journey from spirit into matter, incarnation, so that those beings incarnated with a 3-strand DNA model. This required a great deal of skill on the part of the midwives as they chaperoned the spirit through the portals into physical incarnation, so that the souls came in whole and with a firm foundation to serve a higher purpose. The primary motive behind this was that with this 3-strand DNA model, the spirit would retain its memory banks from the Akashic fields along with its gifts and talents. And most importantly, this 3-strand DNA model prevented the spirit incarnate from being blinded by the veils of amnesia. In other words, it retained its knowledge of oneness and connection with Source. But the most interesting revelation that came through the session was that the 3-strand DNA model was a prerequisite for the spirit incarnate to escape the loop of death and rebirth on the 3D Earth reality, which is a wicked and vicious circle and seemingly impossible to be released off, and it keeps a spirit in captive servitude for eternity. Not surprisingly, these midwives of the Order of Isis were hunted down and eliminated, and this order went underground in ancient Chem, and all the information with regard to this aspect was distorted to keep spirit in a perpetual loop of servitude, the death and rebirth cycle. Another very interesting revelation that came during the session was that the activations that followed through came from the 13 dimensions, not the 12 as one, but 13 distinct dimensions, We often speak of our goal as activating our 12-strand DNA and beyond, but I was clearly shown that while the 12 strands merely complete the balance of the masculine and feminine, it is the 13th as a separate identity that holds within it the forward future outcome potential. I have been working on the connection of the 13 with the 22, the consciousness of 22 via the Intergalactic Council of 22 Star Nations, and while there are a lot of puzzle pieces missing from my awareness conscious understanding, it is my knowing that while the consciousness of 22 requires an alignment with 22 past the 13 itself forms the very bridge to the 22. Also, interestingly, the date 4-4, April 4, has come up in multiple sessions now and can no longer be ignored. While the sessions are all vastly and uniquely different in terms of intention and channeling, and clients' individual spiritual growth, many have been given the 4-4 date as significant in their individual journey of soul progression. Much gratitude to my dearly beloved client soul sister for giving permission to share these excerpts from her session. Again, not sure how this information is relevant today on the 3-3 portal day, but I'm also told to use it as per your guidance. And pouring out your guidance, happy 3-3 portal day. Be light in light and joy. 22-2-2020, the new light was born from the darkest night of the year, Maha Shivrati, February 21, at the stroke of midnight, 12 a.m., 22 February, from the dark womb of creation, a light will be born, the light of the consciousness of 22, the intergalactic 22 star nations, the emperor plus empress, the foundation plus manifest potential, 2202-2020 equal 10, equal alpha plus omega. This is from isischannelings.wordpress.com. And from the Archangelic Calendar, Lightworkers on Call, the Expanding 8888 Gate, Breaking the Chains, and Archangel Zophiel's Intelligence. Gaia is firmly set in the element of water. This means whatever is happening affects us long term. This also confirms that we will be continuing to see strong incoming and upgrades that are too numerous to list. We can say for certain is that our extended star ancestors are reaching out much like Mysa did. The 8888 gate is open, which is an ever wider version of yesterday's 888 gate. It also means that we are moments away from the hard timeline shift that we are about to orchestrate. We were told by Archangel Michael that this would be necessary for a positive timeline shift. It should feel like a bit like quantum leaping between two starships at ludicrous speeds, because on the higher dimensions, that is exactly what we are doing. Once we make that switch, we must be ready to administer tremendous power to gain the control of the alternative timeline in which we have just entered. We will not have those codes until the day of, so please keep a close eyes watch. When the time is right, we will push Lemuria back into her ideal position and administer enough complete shrines to make up the difference. This will be handled by the Dragon Legion, as they are a very patient legion who specializes in such structures. We only need to assist in placing Lemuria back into position. Once she overshoots her mark, we must be ready within a moment's notice, as this will be a time-sensitive assignment of the uttermost priority. Archangel Elion is very active, and for those of us who do not know him, he is the Sheriff's Department of the Archangelic Legion. He is not particularly fond of the ruling class, and I am sure we will be hearing reports of his doing shortly. I cannot say enough about Archangel Zophiel and the level of speed and accuracy in which he administers his intelligence reports. He wishes to inform us that social media is the gauge in which organized darkness decides whether or not to proceed with their plans. This means that the more that you expose their agenda, the better the chances that they will have to turn to an alternative and less thought-out plan. This is very relevant to the coronavirus, as this has infected social media more than anything else. And this is something that is a distraction, and also something that we are healing and rising up from. So we stay out of the fear, stay into the heart, and know that the power within you is much more powerful than anything in this realm. Anything they can throw out with any kind of frequency, with any kind of technology. Know that you have the power within you to resolve, dissolve, and transform anything that is projected towards us. The 7777 coming in. The assignments today, the assignments are valid any day. Please make sure you're using today's current weaponry. If you're seeing this 30 or so hours after this was posted, please use your intuition. And we have the links below each video, each transmission for the full transcription of these daily transmissions. So you can always find them in the link below in the description. And they're all archived on our website, primedisclosure.com. We have over 1,000 now. You can check those out daily. One, yesterday we went over the difference between the universe and infinitely expanding creator source for great reason, as today we will break the chains that bind the universe. Our universe is painfully anchored to a parasitic universe by a heavy grayish white chain that was imbued by a race that is long extinct. We use any means necessary to break these chains. This will manifest in a wave of relief when it hits our dimension. If we have dotted out I's and crossed our T's properly, this will be felt by every conscious being in the universe. 2. Gaia's inner workings have ducts that help filter her oceans. They have been manipulated and do not work properly. Pop the silicon-like substance on the bottom of these lakes located under the oceans and allow the ducts to drain. Please take care to not get any of the silicon-like substance on you. If you do, you will need assistance to remove it. You can puncture this substance from the top or travel under the lake and drain it from the bottom. Either way, make sure it's moving well before you leave. 3. If it resonates, affirm permission to the galaxy to administer next level upgrades to your being. You will need to consciously choose this upgrade in order to be able to partake in it. And this is from the Archangelic Calendar.wordpress.com. And today from Amanda Lawrence. The Forerunners now begin their individual yet consciously aware exit from the collective matrix system. The grand divine plan unfolding is that they have best served the whole at their highest attainable energetic frequency by being consciously outside of the whole 3D and 4D system of containment during the month of March 2020 while retaining the body. So their exit from the illusion begins, and simultaneously the rising out of the individual programming of their small mind. The whole play, dream, illusion, and how it works is viewed from outside of it. Thus we are free to give of our highest energy frequency to Gaia and to the whole as we go. So perfect. All to play for now. Keep going. So much love sent. One love, Amanda Lawrence. 711-711 coming in now with the 3322. And from Honey Borden, 33 Ascension Gateway Portal. Ascension journey is a journey of remembering, readjusting, recentering, rebalancing, recollaborating, and reconnecting to the original divine blueprint. Each of us are on that journey, and we will all gather there. Some are further along, and some are further back, and all will arrive one way or another, as it is part of the divine plan. These alignments assist us in the calibration of the light stream we are able to carry within, as density has transmuted out of our fields. Some days it is very intense, such as today, and some days it is light and all is well. Our gratitude is the ascension attitude. Thus focus inward where you on your spectrum and bring the goods through with each stepping cosmic stone of expansion and more of your divine truth. Love and gratitude, Honi B. Aho. From Elizabeth, Peru, 3333, the power day of the way shower, defender of the underdog, walking between worlds, overcoming self-doubt, ever loyal and dependable, embodying discipline, dedication, consistency, stepping into the role of leader and champion. Beloved ones, today on this Tuesday, 3-3, is the global power day of 33. The energy we began on 1-1 now accelerates threefold. This is a day to do and be something special that is aligned with your soul, your infinite path of light. From ElizabethPeru.com. Today from the Zulkin Times, Kin 234, White Cosmic Wizard. Today is the last day of the wave spell. The 13th day is called Cosmic, and keywords associated with it are endure, presence, and transcend. This symbolizes that all journeys worth taking are difficult. Progress is not handed out on a plate. You have to earn it in the hard way. Today is White Wizard, which represents enchantment, receptivity, and timelessness. As I have said before, the first day of a wave spell sets the agenda and begins the 13-day journey. The cosmic day is the final destination. So what have we learnt during this white wind wave spell? Did you focus on communication? Did you see some change in your life due to the storm and occult position? Today, the wizard wields great power, but it can be unforgiving due to the number 13. You may feel a bit bewildered. You can be a wizard too and enchant someone, or you can be the one enchanted. It is up to you. From Christina Papagiorgio, White Cosmic Wizard, Kin 234, 3 March 2020, Power of Enchanting Magic. 332020 equal 334 equal 64 equal 10 equal 1. 33, a double Holy Spirit Day. 3, Holy Trinity, Joy, Creativity, Communication. 6, Heaven, Christ, Harmony. 4, Angelic Form, Earth, Foundation. 10, Manifestation, Authority, Leadership. 1, New Beginnings, Original. Kin 234 equal 9, Divine Destiny, Service, Compassion, Humanity, Closure. An uber powerful, heavenly, magical manifestation day. Today is day 13, 14, due to leap day, which is the last day in the web spell of Icke, the white wind who holds the power of spirit and communication, where we are becoming hollow vessels for spirit to communicate and operate through our being. We commenced our journey on day 1 with the white magnetic wind, feeling the gentle breeze of the white wind whispering in our ear, encouraging us to purify our vessel, our mind, body, and spirit to create more space for spirit to enter and guide us. Today we conclude that journey, arriving at a place of total cosmic expansion where we embody spirit in every cell of our being, reaching the state of transcendence where we are one with spirit and all that is. Welcome home, dear starseeds. Tone of creation. Cosmic is the last and final tone of creation. The highest octave, tone 13, operates in the spiritual realm. 13 is the goddess code. It is the frequency of the natural world, the 13 moon calendar, the cosmos, and all that is. The cosmic power is that of presence, existing in the eternal now moment. Cosmic is the fourth and final of the spiritual realm tones. Notably, all the other realms, physical, mental, and emotional, only have 3 tones. Cosmic action transcends power, endures essence, presence. We commence and end the cosmic dance of the 13 tones with spiritual energies from magnetic through to cosmic completion, through the action of transcendence evolving through each level of being until you simply just are, through your journey of purification, attuning, listening, communicating, and channeling. You have fully embodied your God self. Today you have incredible spiritual power at your disposal to transcend the old you, the old paradigm, the old world, and old reality. They all dissolve into the cosmic mists. We can transform them by our pure intelligent presence, translating into pure harmony and beauty. We have arrived. Add some. I am here. This is the stage of having transcended the physical, emotional, and mental realms and arriving at cosmic consciousness. So today we can be still and realize the connectedness of all things through the web of creation, transcending all but the power of pure divine harmony and grace through the frequency of pure internal presence. It is time to realign with your universal I am presence and upgrade your consciousness through your new and expanded divine purpose. 13 is the final tone of creation, bringing us to completion, aligning with the Kin 234 equal 9 code, the conclusion of one cycle, overlapping with the commencement of the new cycle, daily code equal plus 1 new beginnings. So today is a day of endings and new beginnings all wrapped into one, the Alpha and the Omega, one continuous eternal cycle repeating over and over. The in-breath and the out-breath of Creator forever flowing, expanding and contracting in the eternal cosmic dance of creation. Happy galactic birthday, Carl Jung. Note, Carl Jung, the famous psychoanalyst, is a white cosmic wizard. Jung claimed that the key to healing his clients was through the powerful healing force of enchantment. He held incredible presence and was able to travel to the depths of our collective psyches to uncover the mysteries of our minds and subconscious patterns, going to realms beyond where one had ever ventured. Indelibly, he was a brilliant wizard healer. I am the master magician of my life. And so we now complete the 13-day white wind wave spell and we take flight into the cosmos, having perfected our union with spirit through the white wind, the all-encompassing everything that is the cosmic 13 perfectly transcends, taking magic flight and then returning to the one once again. A new tribe, that of the visionary seer, the majestic blue eagle, takes the helm as host of the new wave spell commencing tomorrow in our grand adventure through the revelations of the dream spell. Today's question is, how can I become more receptive to the pure, endless presence of God consciousness in my being, allowing spirit to manifest magical miracles through me? Divine blessings, and may your magical manifestations be applauded throughout the cosmos with harm to none. In Lakek Alakin, Christina White, Magnetic World Bridger, Kin 66. A little tongue tied there. Let's give it a shot. And from the Harmonic Convergence 2020, Kin 234, and the Timeless Magic Flight of Quetzalcoatl, March 3rd, 2020. Written 332020 corresponds to Kin 234, 13 Wizard, and marks today the last day of the wave spell of the wind spirit that started 13 days ago on Kin 222, one wind, and synchronized with several events of special prophetic significance. February 24, 2020. NS 1.32.8.18, Kin 227-6 hand, marked a prophetic master milestone of 33 years, 13 plus 20, or 11 plus 22, since the discovery of SN1987A, Quetzalcoatl, the brightest extragalactic supernova ever recorded on Earth. This event was the celestial confirmation of the Quetzalcoatl prophecy of the 13 heavens and the 9 hells underworlds brought forth by American author Tony Shearer in his book Lord of the Dawn, 1971. This prophecy was embraced by Jose and Lloydine R. Willis, who organized the Harmonic Convergence of 1987, the first synchronized global meditation on Earth, in August 16-17, 1987, to commemorate its fulfillment. Day one of this wave spell precisely corresponded to Shearer's Galactic Return number 131. From the perspective of fractal time, the completion of this milestone has a deep harmonic significance, considering several factors. It was Tony Shearer who first introduced the 1320 permutation matrix to Jose R. Willis back in the early 70s, and Kin 222 synchronized with the eve of the 20.02.2020 time portal. Therefore, we just completed a perfect half of the 260-unit matrix board, where each unit corresponds to one Zolkin matrix of 260 days, each instead to one kin. Within this fractal 1320 matrix comprised of 200 Zolkins, Unit 131 is located at the heart of Harmonic 33 of the 1320 harmonic module and marks the start of the second perfect set of 130 units to complete 260 cycles of 260 days each. The year 2020 marks the completion of 7 cycles of 7 years, each since the original publication of The Lord of the Dawn in 1971, and 5 cycles of 5 years, each since the publication of the second edition of the book in 1995. So there's the 7-7 and the 5-5 energies. To commemorate this prophetic milestone of 49 years since the publication of this prophecy, Tortuga1320.com is reproducing some excerpts of the prelude added by the author for the 1995 revised edition, where he narrates the story of a man and a manuscript. According to the back cover of the book, the prelude also tells how the story came to be published, about the author's triumphs and vicissitudes in spreading the message of the Lord of the Dawn, and how the amazing prophecy has been and is being fulfilled. In Dreamspell, Cosmology Kin 234, 13 Wizard marks the 13th tone, or the magic flight of the wind. So today is a perfect opportunity to revisit this prophetic prelude to the second edition entitled The Quest and the Manuscript, A New Flight of Quetzalcoatl. This is a love story. The story is set within the framework of a terrible yet wonderful prophecy, the prophecy of the 13 heavens and 9 hells. The prophecy was carved on the rocks of the sacred city of Palenque in southern Mexico more than 1,500 years ago. Carved in glyphs and based on intricate mathematical calculations, it calls for near to utter destruction of all things in Indian America, but it promised a beautiful and harmonious new world for those who keep the covenant with the Creator and the Earth Mother. Prelude to the Lord of the Dawn by Tony Shearer. August 16, 1987 came and went. The prophecy was true for those with the eyes to see. Millions of people all over the world rose up and honored it, but even millions more had never heard of it. August 16, 1987 lives on in our hearts. Never give up the dream, the hope. Fight on in peace. Someday we will win. The world cannot long endure under non-spiritual ways of thinking. The prophecy shook the world but enough to awaken us completely. Not enough to mend the lives broken by greed and cruelty. Not enough to unite the planet under one banner dedicated to freedom and justice for all. But there are millions of people who really believe that a new world should happen, that someday in the future, when we finally get it right, it will happen. Maybe it already has. All we can do now is wait and see. I am often asked by students, if Quetzalcoatl was alive today, how would we know him? My answer to that question is always the same. Quetzalcoatl is alive today as it has ever been. You will find it in your heart. He is the voice that teaches you to be loyal and compassionate to your friends and loved ones. He is the echo that tells you the earth is truly your mother and the sky is truly your father. He is the teaching that tells us again and again that respect for the rights of others is peace, that we should make every act in our life a creative one, create beauty, inspire peace and harmony, create trust, aid the weak and needy, and meditate daily. Above all else, be honest to your own heart. Quetzalcoatl lives, as always, in the good things of the world, the same place that Christ, Buddha, Muhammad, and Baha'u'llah will be found, healing the pains of us all. Lord of the Dawn, Prelude to the Second Edition, 1995. The Quest and the Manuscript, A New Flight of Quetzalcoatl. The Affirmation for Kin 234, White Cosmic Wizard. The Mantra, the Code is, I endure in order to enchant. Transcending receptivity, I seal the output of timelessness with the cosmic tone of presence. I am guided by the power of endlessness. And there we have it, eternal ones, beloved beings of light. Let us know in the comments below this video what you're feeling, what you're experiencing, what your visions, your dreams, what you see shining through the veils as we are being uplifted, upleveled, and upgraded through the cosmic codes of cosmic consciousness. And with these Venus energies coming in fully now, the Venusians are connecting with us in the higher realms, in the dream realms, and in our meditations, and in our daily practices. We're feeling this on many levels. So coming through was the connection of Nikola Tesla being a Venusian, and also the master teacher, who many call Jesus in this timeline, is believed to be Venusian of the Venus energies, the divine compassionate goddess of love. And it also came through that as the teacher, we would call him Jesus or Yeshua Christos of Venus. So the Jesus or Yeshua of Venus is fully activated now within the hearts, within the threefold flame of each and every one of you. You that is listening now to these words is being fully activated. Feel it in your heart center, the threefold Trinity flames. Through the rainbow bridge, the seven kings of Revelation 17, with the quell, the Q energy of Source. Breaking the timelines, breaking free of all time loops. We're being activated now. Feel into that. The seven kings are the seven chakras, the seven colors of the electromagnetic spectrum, the rainbow bridge, fully open, fully activated. The doorways, the portals, fully open here today. It is up to you, Divine One, to step through and be fully activated. Step into your light, step into your glory, and step into your sovereignty. 737 just coming through, of course, here in this moment. 7337, heaven on earth, the kingdom of heaven within, on earth as it is in heaven. The internal mirrors the external, and the external mirrors the internal. So that is why we are the event. We are the awakening ones of the great awakening. So time to wake up and step forward, step forth into the light, walking your divine path with heart, warriors of love, of the Venusian energy activated now. The 12 into the 13, fully active. The 144, rising up, rising up, rising up. And if you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe. Click the subscribe button below and the little bell next to subscribe to get notifications on future uploads. Many people are saying that they're not getting the notifications, so be sure to check if you're still subscribed and click the bell. Ding! So here we have it, beloveds. I bid you all adieu here. Have a beautiful and blessed day. And now I will read to you with the heart of the Venusian coming through this voice here now. Be in your heart. Be in peace. Namaste.
A heads up. A rallying cry as we ride alongside the four horsemen of the apocalypse. Here's to the fallen, the broken, and the shattered, to the warriors who know that to be cracked is to let the light in deeper, who know that the best fruit is on the very tip of the branch and the brightest jewels are hidden within the roughest of surfaces. Here's to the ones intoxicated by the burning of the winds of change in their lungs and who live in the lands that others fear to tread. Here's to the ones who raise their voices to the heavens even though they don't always know the words. Here's to the rare beings who walk the road less traveled, taking the adventure that rises on this path with purpose and passion. Here's to the rebels, the heart-sick originals, and the bittersweet loneliness that fuels their spirit. To the ones who won't conform, back down, or step aside. To the ones who are not born to fit in, but to gloriously stand out. To those who are here to be midwives of the genuine. Here's to the awakened ones whose purpose is to feed their soul and not starve it, whose mantra is the drumbeat of their own heart. Here's to the magical, the mystical, and the misunderstood, to the wise ones who move between the shadows and the light, to those who read the compass written on the walls of their hearts and follow the North Star etched upon their spirit. Here's to the brightly colored patchwork of divine visionaries that won't stand down, play small, or sit out, to the stargazers, the storm chasers, and the old souls that walk this earth. Here's to the wild ones. Here's to you, Rebel Society.